Hello, my friends. Becoming an instructional designer just got a whole lot easier thanks to the help of AI. So for the past several months, I've spent a lot of my time building and refining these AI tools to help you along your journey to become an instructional designer and learn about instructional design overall. So yeah, things are a little bit different now. Also, as of today, I'm making these tools available for free. So, you know, in this video, I'll show you how they work and I'll tell you how to access them. But yeah, times are a little bit different than they were in 2017 when I was getting into this field. I spent a lot of time networking and trying to get on coffee chats with people and asking questions in online forums and asking my girlfriend or my wife, now my girlfriend at the time, to like come over and look at what I was building every 10 minutes to give me feedback on the visuals. So all of those things are still important, right? You still want feedback from real people and like networking is still key, but now we have that, you know, 24/7 instantaneous feedback and guidance in the form of AI. And instead of having to rely on like the base version of ChatGPT, which might not really be an instructional design expert, I've created these tools that are trained on our process that, you know, we know works for helping people get hired and on every single one of my 400 plus YouTube videos. So I want to show you what we're working with here. So this is our community space, and you can see I ask the AI this question, you know, how do I write good learning objectives? I want to create an e-learning course for new instructional designers, you know, and I want some solid learning objectives to guide the experience. So then within like 60 seconds, this is the response you'll get from this new AI tool. So you know, it's like, yeah, this is a solid first step. Start by using Bloom's taxonomy to make sure that they are measurable. Instead of using words like understand, use these other verbs from Bloom's. And then you can notice it links to a YouTube video.
How to actually write those objectives. I mean, that's what this is.
So this is 4 years old, but yeah, it can instantly pull from like very specific 30-second clips that are most relevant to your question based on my entire library of YouTube content. So I think you're going to, you know, you can have some fun with this one. It might link to the same clip multiple times and whatnot, but yeah, you know, this will lead to more effective learning experience. You can find more insights in this clip. So we have all of these different clips.
Writing these things.
So yeah, so this will be a really great way. Like if you don't know if I have a YouTube video on something or not, you could ask this a question here in the community. And this bot is really solid at finding them. I did a video several months back where I show how I created like the first version of this bot, but I made it like way more in depth and hopefully a lot better. I can't tell you how many hundreds of hours I've spent working on this behind the scenes, and it's not as perfect as I'd like, but it still does a pretty good job. And you can access this now in the community with this Ask Devlin.ai link right here. If you're not in the community, you can go to devlinpeck.com/ID for instructional design. I'll share that with you here. So here's the link to join the community if you're not in there already. And if you are, you can just go to community.devlinpeck.com. So as of right now, I turned on this AI bot in this space, in the working in the field space, the transitioning to ID space, and I have it introducing you as well, sharing any helpful links and giving you like a nice personalized introduction. So let me know what you think about this. I just turned it on for everyone yesterday. Yeah, and let's see, I asked it another question, like, can you help me come up with a good portfolio project idea? And it's like, absolutely, right? You want to choose projects that resonate with your personal interests. You know, for example, if you're, you know, if you like pickleball, you could do a e-learning about the rules of that. That's an exact example I used in one of my recent videos. So you can see it gets very specific. It links to these very, you know, specific clips for your question. And yeah, I want to obviously keep refining this. So if you do test this out, you know, you could have fun with it. We even had Scott on our team, like, ask it, what's the meaning of life? And then we get to see what this AI bot's view of life is based on all of the content in my YouTube video. So you can ask fun questions if you want, like, you know, have some fun with it, right? I put it here for you. So don't worry about like, oh, is this a worthwhile question or not? You know, ask it whatever you want. And then, yeah, the only downside is if I don't have a YouTube video on a topic, it might not be the strongest response, but I do have some other tools to share with you. Oh, and then just to show you like how to use this. Yeah, you can go to one of these spaces, click the new post button right here, and then just type in whatever you want into these questions right here. Like, what are the best AI tools to learn? And then you can just publish it. And then with it, within 60 seconds, there should be a response, but you will have to refresh it. It won't appear here automatically. So I'll leave that open. We'll take a look back at it soon. So let's take a look at this become an instructional designer bot. So we also, if you don't want it to be like a public community post, I enabled this thing here where you can send direct messages to an AI bot that's trained on our approach and our content. So you can go to this direct messages tab up here, and then either in the inbox or the agents tab, you'll see this agent right here. So we can click on that, and then you can just start having a conversation. So this one is trained on a lot of resources that are in our community. So like prior conversations that have happened in the community, as well as our approach overall, like how to approach building a portfolio, how to approach breaking into the field. And notice I just asked like, how do I get started? And then it wants to personalize its advice for you. So, you know, could you let me know if you have any prior experience in idea related field? I just said, I'm coming from teaching. And it's like, great, this is common. You already have transferable skills. What specific goals do you have in mind for your career? And then I just said like corporate. And it's like, okay, great. Here is, you know, here are some steps to get you started. And then if you've been watching many of our videos, you can tell like, this is like the process we kind of recommend here. So I asked how to create my portfolio. It mentions, you know, a flagship project that's scenario based and story driven using Articulate Storyline 360, one or two supporting projects. So it is very, very trained on our process here that we've been teaching in the bootcamp, that we've been teaching on YouTube, that's been working for people for years now. And you can see it can support some additional resources as well, like this creating an ID portfolio post, which is quite extensive, as you can see. So these are two new tools that are available for free that haven't been enabled before. This one is not trained on the same level of like YouTube content as like the public one is. So let's refresh this. We have our comment now. And let's see, highly recommend tools like ChatGPT, Claude, and Jasper. Check out more. Kristen discusses using ChatGPT alongside these tools here. Let's see.
Our third and final tool.
Nice.
The third tool that might come.
So we have a whole segment from Kristen Dominguez on ChatGPT that it found and linked to. Let's see, prompt engineering. So let's open this one.
So here are my top three tools.
Five essential AI skills. So you can see it really finds the best YouTube content we have for your question, and it will link right to it. So I'm really excited for you to try this. If you're open to it, and you can just reply to the bot and like share your feedback, you know, do like 5 out of 10, you know, link to the same video twice, or like 10 out of 10, never found this video super helpful. Like your feedback is going to help me make the final boss version of this tool, which eventually I would like to have just like a, you know, a web URL you can go to with all of our different specialized AI tools there, like, you know, the YouTube research tool that is trained on all of our YouTube videos, a portfolio feedback tool, an Articulate Storyline 360 like help bot that is like really good at Storyline 360 support. So that's the final vision for this. Obviously we're building on it as we go, and yeah, your feedback back is really helping shape the direction for like what's most valuable. So yeah, if you want the YouTube bot, use one of the community spaces. If you want like a private general, like become an ID support, you can use this bot right here that you can send direct messages to. And then finally, we have this custom GPT. So this was like the first version of this AI help in becoming an ID. It seems like y'all have been liking it, right? We have some 4 and 5 star reviews. I wish people could comment and like tell me like what would bring it to that 5-star mark, but I have been getting a lot of private feedback. Most of it's positive. So if you have used this and have any like constructive feedback for how to make it better, again, all ears, please like drop a comment on this video. But I've made this prompt even better. So we have been refining this prompt to make this bot here more effective. I'll share a link to this one in the comments. But you can do really cool stuff with this one. So for example, I found an open role on Indeed here, just for a senior instructional design role. I also pulled up one of my resume from 2020. So I don't really have much more recent resumes than that since I've been running my own business here. And looking at this 2020 resume, I see so many opportunities to make it better based on everything I've learned over the past 5 years. But yeah, here's what we have, right? I have my freelancing experience, my team lead experience from like this ID company I worked at, and then my experience at Apple as well. I have some keywords, so on and so forth. But yeah, I wanted to make it better, of course. So I threw it into this custom GPT I made to help you become an instructional designer. And yeah, I pasted the whole job description. And I said, how can I better tailor my resume for this open role? I just pasted in all of that, uploaded my resume, and then here we go. So this company is looking for someone who, you know, does this stuff. Here are my strengths. And then here are the suggested improvements. So it's saying to, you know, make the seniority more obvious. For example, I could, you know, use principal instructional designer as the job title here instead of like e-learning developer and instructional designer, which I think is great feedback there, especially since it's like my own company. So that's more flexible. It's mentioning adding these specific instructional design frameworks. So Addy, Kirkpatrick, Sam, etc. Emphasizing soft skills more. So, you know, facilitated SME interviews, presented learning strategies to executive leadership. These would be great. And obviously it's very tailored to like what the role is looking for. Mention, you know, a variety of different learning formats since that's what the role is looking for. So yeah, the best part about the custom GPT is that you can do file uploads. So you could like upload screenshots of your e-learning projects and ask how to improve the visual design. I've heard people really like turning to this to ask about like probability of like how soon they could land roles meeting their specific criteria and the best action plan for making that happen. People go to it for like emotional support when they're feeling discouraged. It helps like ground people and like the numbers and like, you know, the likelihood of success if they actually do the steps that are laid out for them. So this is the one that has been publicly available. Again, I just updated the prompt to make it a little bit better based off some of the feedback I have gotten. And this is available for free as well. So yes, I hope that, you know, this 24/7 support will make your journey a whole lot easier. Again, you can access... I really want to see you in the community and like see how you like the YouTube one, because that's the one I've put like the most time and effort into just to kind of make the most of this huge archive of YouTube content we have. So please check out that one, even if it's just to ask like some silly questions or some questions you already know the answer to and you just want to like see how it performs, because yeah, that one's my baby a little bit compared to all of these other ones. But the goal with all of them is to help make your life a lot easier, to help you feel more supported in your journey to become an ID. And yeah, if you want to check them all out, head on over to devlinpeck.com/ID, and I'll see you in the community.